Valence bond theory. Valence bond theory also can correctly predict the geometries for expanded valence type molecules. There is a hybridization which also occurs that can explain the electronic geometries in such cases. Let's take a look at two common examples, one in which phosphorus exists as a stable molecule with an expanded valence, for example, phosphorus pentachloride, and also we'll take a look at an example with sulfur, because sulfur as well can form compounds with expanded valence, sulfur hexafluoride, for example. First, let's look at the phosphorus. The electron configuration for phosphorus in its ground state is 3s2 3p3, because there are five valence electrons. So what can happen then, how can we end up then with only four orbitals ending up with five new hybrid shapes that we see that fall out into the position that is the trigonal bipyramidal electronic arrangement. Trigonal bipyramidal is what we call it when we have five regions of high electron density around the central atom. Well, if you'll remember, according to the rules that came from the Schrodinger equation, you can actually have, when you're in the third main energy level, you can have available to you s, p, and d orbitals. Now, as it turns out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, as it turns out, in the case of phosphorus, the d orbitals in the ground state are not populated with electrons. Nevertheless, their positions are available. So what happens is, in the case of the five regions of high electron density, we have hybridization of five individual atomic orbitals, one s orbital, three p orbitals, and one d orbital. And this new, and I'll take it over here so we can see what we're doing, 3s, and then we had the 3p, 1, 2, 3, with three electrons, and then available to us again is the 3d, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And what happens is five of those orbitals combine to give five new, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, new orbitals, and the name of those new hybridized orbitals is called sp3d, indicating what was combined in order to make them, and then we still have the remaining four 3d atomic orbitals left untouched. But these five new sp3d orbitals then arrange themselves in space as far apart as possible in this trigonal bipyramidal shape. So anytime we have trigonal bipyramidal electron configuration, we can expect to have sp3d hybridization. And an analogous story for the sulfur, there's four electrons in the valence shell. We still have, even though it's not populated, available is calculated orbitals for the 3d. And so what happens in this case is we have six new orbitals combined from six atomic orbitals, an s, three p's, and two d's. And so this particular hybrid situation, they're renamed sp3d2, indicating the number of pure orbitals that were combined. And then we still have three 3d's left untouched in this case. And so you can see how in this case the six valence electrons can spread out. And you form these six new hybrid orbitals that are all as far apart in space as possible, giving us the octahedral electron configuration, octahedral electronic geometry, which is what we always see when we have the sp3d2 hybridization. So for the expanded valence, we can have sp3d or sp3d2.